فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى today we're going to be talking about أحكام rulings pertaining to praying on the chair. This is one of the most common issues that people bring to me. They ask me regarding what is the ruling, the ahkam, pertaining to praying on a chair. And this has become an epidemic, that the Muslims are. You rarely come to a masjid except you find one or two people praying on a chair. And then when you observe those people who are praying, you realize they don't follow the rulings pertaining to it and the ahkam that they need to come with. Or you sometimes find people who are able to pray standing up, choose to pray sitting on a chair. If you travel and you go on a plane, you find the people pray sitting on the aeroplane, on the chair, instead of standing up and praying. So this is something that needs to be properly understood, or else this may have a problem on the prayer. My beloved brothers and sisters who are listening to me, the scholars and the people of knowledge, they gave a lot of importance to the matters of salah. Either talking about it, authoring a book regarding it, and whatnot. So don't take it lightly and think to yourself that this topic is a very light topic. Are you going to designate a whole lecture on this topic? There are many more other important things to talk about. Kalla wallahi. That's not the case. Because the salah is the greatest thing after the shahadatain. After ashadu an la ilaha illallah and وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ What comes is the salah. So the way I plan بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ الْكَرِيمِ to go through this topic is as follows. I'm going to break it into three parts, inshallah ta'ala. Today, inshallah ta'ala, today's lecture بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ الْكَرِيمِ first part, is going to be مُقَدِّمَاتْ عَامَّة general introductions, which I will speak about قَوَاعِدْ and أَحْكَامْ which are very important for one to understand. And this is not min al-tawti'ah, it's a type of introduction. You see? So you're going to have an understanding before we go into the topic. Then inshallah ta'ala, the second part, bi-idhni Allah al-kareem, is going to be the body and the main topic at hand, which is the hukum and the rulings pertaining to sitting on a chair. And the last one inshallah ta'ala is going to be a conclusion. It's going to be a khulasa, a conclusion, bullet pointing everything we spoke about. So you have a better understanding, because sometimes I might go out and I might come, but at the last point, I'm going to give you point 1, point 2, point 3, point 4, so you are upon clarity, inshallah ta'ala. So I'm going to start with the introduction right now, bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. As I had said right now, the most important thing after the shahadatain is what? As-salah. And the salah is a pillar in which a person's religion stands on. And a person's Islam does not exist if the prayer is not present. And the prayer doesn't also exist. So your Islam does not exist without a prayer. And your prayer doesn't also exist unless you come with prerequisites, which are shurut, and unless you come with the arkan, the pillars, and the wajibat. And of course, your prayer would exist, but to also come with the sunan, the recommended. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Quran, Surah Al-Mu'minun, Ayah 1 to Ayah 2, Allah says, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Success and prosperity is for the believers. Who are they? الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. Those who find in their prayer khushu'. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Prosperity is for the believers. Which ones? الَّذِينَ, the ones, الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ, the ones who find khushu' in their prayer, humility. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ كِتَابًا مَوْقُوتًا. That the prayer is on the believers. إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. The prayer is to the believers. كِتَابًا مَوْقُوتًا, a designated time. The salah has been made obligatory on the Muslims at a particular time. It has awqat. Times you have to pray. There's time for asr, time for dhuhr, sorry. There's time for asr, maghrib, isha, fajr. Every one of them, it has a time. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says in Surah At-Tawbah, Ayah 11, فَإِنْ تَابُوا, if they repent, وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ, and they establish the prayer, وَآتَوُوا الزَّكَاةَ, and they give the zakat, فَإِخْوَانُكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ, they are your brothers in faith. So their repentance is connected to what? فَإِنْ تَابُوا, if they repent, وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ, and they establish the prayer, وَآتَوُوا الزَّكَاةَ, and they give the zakat, فَإِخْوَانُكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ, then they are your brothers in faith. So the ayah is telling us, if they don't do that, they are not our brothers in faith. That is the mafhum of the ayah. And this is the ayah that the scholars used, that anyone who leaves the prayer is a disbeliever. وَقَوْلُهُ, also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Maryam, Ayah 59, فَخَلَفَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ خَلْفٌ أَضَاعُ الصَّلَاةَ وَاتَّبَعُ الشَّهَوَاتِ فَسَوْفَ يَلْقَوْنَ غَيَّا. فَخَلَفَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ خَلْفٌ أَضَاعُ الصَّلَاةَ وَاتَّبَعُ الشَّهَوَاتِ فَسَوْفَ يَلْقَوْنَ غَيَّا. After them came a people. أَضَاعُوا الصَّلَاةَ, they forsake the prayer. وَاتَّبَعُوا الشَّهَوَاتِ, and they follow their desires. So forsaking the prayer is you follow your desires. If you forsake the prayer, your person is following his whims and his desires. فَسَوْفَ يَلْقَوْنَ غَيًّا, they're going to be thrown into what? غَيًّا, as Ibn Abbas said, is what? Is a valley in Jahannam. وَقَوْلُهُ, also Allah تبارك وتعالى, He says in Surah Al-Mudathir, Ayah 43, after Allah spoke about مَا سَلَكَكُمْ فِي سَقَرْ قَالُوا لَمْ نَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُصَلِّينَ وَلَمْ نَكُمْ نُطْعِمُ الْمِسْكِينَ وَكُنَّا نَخُوضُ مَعَ الْخَائِضِينَ وَكُنَّا نُكَذِّبُ بِيَوْمِ الدِّينَ حَتَّى أَتَانَ الْيَقِينَ. Al-yaqeen means until death came to us. So what was it that brought them to the hellfire? قَالُوا لَمْ نَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُصَلِّينَ. We were not from those who used to pray. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, فَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ. Wail be to those who pray. Which ones? الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَاهُونَ. Those who delay their prayer, who come with their prayer deficient. Also, Al-Imam Al-Bukhari and Muslim, they both narrated in the Sahih, min hadith Abdullah ibn Umar, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Bunya al-Islamu ala khamsin, shahadati an la ilaha illallah, wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, wa iqami al-salah, wa ita'i al-zakah, wa hajji al-bayt, wa sawmi Ramadan. Hadith is collected in Bukhari and Muslim. And then the Prophet tells us in this hadith that the religion is built upon what? Five pillars. The first one of them is what? Shahadati an la ilaha illallah, that there is none worthy of worship except Allah. Wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, and that Muhammad is his what? His messenger. Wa iqamis salati, and establishing the what? Prayer. Al-Imam Ahmad, pay attention here. Al-Imam Ahmad and Ahlul Sunan, Abu Dawood, Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah, and Nasa'i, they narrated in Hadith Buraidah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that the messenger said, Al-ahdu alladhi baynana wa baynahum as-salah. فَمَنْ تَرَكَهَا فَقَدْ كَفَرَ. The covenant between us, وَبَيْنَهُمْ, and between them is the prayer. And anyone who leaves it off, فَقَدْ كَفَرَ, he's a disbeliever. Are you with me? What does it mean, the covenant between us and them? What do you guys understand from this? Yeah?
What makes us different from them?
Yeah?
What makes us believers and makes them kuffar?
Huh? What did you understand from Wazir? The covenant here means the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is talking about the munafiqeen. The thing that gave them isma to dami wal mal, the reason why their blood is sacred and protected, is because they're praying. Hatta wa in kana zahiran. As for us, you, the disbelievers, are in a state of war and fight with us. We're fighting with them. So the thing that we give them a contract and a ahd to them for is the prayer. After the shahadatain, when they come, ashhadu la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, is the prayer. Are you there? If they break this contract, as in like they stop praying, that they become kuffar. So we fight with them like we're fighting with the kuffar. Araftum? Now, brothers, pay attention here. This is a summary of, wallahi, a long discussion that we don't want to open. But this is what? This is what? This hadith, the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam specifically mentions that the person who leaves the prayer is what? فَمَنْ تَرَكَهَا تَرْكَ. The messenger said مجرد الترك, just a mere leaving. He didn't condition it to be out of laziness or not lazy. It doesn't matter. This condition of whether it's laziness or not, the messenger left it unrestrictedly. So it encompasses that. It's in there. And the قاعدة مقررة في أصول الفقه. The قاعدة which the ulama of أصول الفقه agree upon themselves and they take on board, which is what? الدليل, which is ظاهر, apparent. And it is wadih, it's clear in its approach. We can't turn away from evidences which are clear cut for evidences which have ihtimalat in. Are you with me? The evidences that have come pertaining to the one who leaves the prayer are clear cut. فَمَنْ تَرَكَهَا فَقَدْ كَفَرْ. The evidences that those who say, are you with me, that it's not kufr, unless the person leaves it out of juhud, the evidences which they bring are not, it has ihtimal. Possibilities are in there. Other meanings can be taken out of it. So for you to go against a dalil which is this straight and clear to the point, for evidences which are what? Hammalha, that wujuh. Those evidences can take more than one phase, is not right. Also the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in the hadith Sahih Muslim, min hadith Jabir ibn Abdullah radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, that the Messenger said, bayna al-rajuli wa bayna al-kufri tarku salah. These hadiths are not, they are sarih, they are nas, which is what? Bayna al-rajuli wa bayna al-kufri, between a man and disbelief, is just leave of the prayer. The Messenger says, alayhi sallam, tarku salah, to leave the prayer. Then what we see is fahmu sahaba, the sahaba's understanding. How did they understand it? Abdullah ibn Shaqiq, what did he say? Kana sahabatu rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam la yarawna shay'an tarku kufran illa salah. Abdullah ibn Shaqiq said, the companions of the Messenger, they never used to see disbelief for any action a person leaves off other than prayer. Yeah? Ijma'u sahaba. The sahabas unanimously agreed upon. If anybody left the prayer, he's a what? Kafir. So sha'nu salah, the importance of the prayer and where it stands in our religion, is not a very light issue. فَقَدْ تَوَارَتِ الْأَدِلَّةِ. The evidences have come in multitude narrations. And evidences have come in multitude. In the Kitab and the Sunnah. And also ijma' consensus have come regarding ala fadli salati, the virtues of the prayer. Wa targhibi fi fi'liha, and urging and pushing the people to pray the salah. Wa ala khatari tahawuni biha, and also the dangers and how serious it is if a person is careless about it. Wa targhibi min tarkiha. So because the prayer has that importance, as I said, and your religion, your Islam, is connected to this prayer. Without it, you're not. Without it, you are not what? Without it, you're not a Muslim. ولذلك when Ahlul Sunnah said الإيمان قول وعمل, the iman is قول, speech, and it is عمل and action, the first thing they were referring to was the prayer. That the action a person has to come with to prove his iman and to show that he has belief is what? Is to pray. If he does not pray and he doesn't, then the claim of having to say that I believe in Allah in the Day of Judgment, it doesn't exist. So as I said to you, your salah is a symbol and a sign for your belief. And if you leave it, you've left Islam. The same is, the salah has conditions and it has prerequisites and it has pillars and it has obligatory things. If you don't come with them, your salah will also not exist. So one of the things that we need to talk about is a pillar. A pillar in the salah. Without it, the salah doesn't exist. And that is standing. A standing in the prayer is a rukun, it's a pillar. And there are many verses in the Quran that show that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in the Quran, وَقُومُوا لِلَّهِ قَانِتِينَ. Stand up for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Qiyam. Also the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where he said, صَلُّوا كَمَا رَأَيْتُمُونِي أُصَلِّي. Pray the way you see me praying. The Prophet prayed standing up. The hadith is Bukhari, narrated it in hadith Malik ibn al-Huwayrith radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Also the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, hadith Sahih al-Bukhari, in hadith Imran ibn Husayn, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what did he say? صَلِّ قَائِمًا. Pray standing up. فَإِن لَمْ تَسْتَطِعْ فَقَاعِدًا. If you can't pray standing up, then sit down. فَإِن لَمْ تَسْتَطِعْ. And if you're not able to pray sitting down, فَعَلَى جَنْبٍ. Then pray on your side. Also the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said in the hadith, الْمُسِيءُ صَلَاتَهُ. The one who was praying incorrectly. And inshallah ta'ala, when we go to the sharh of Sifat Salat al-Nabi, we'll speak more about that narration inshallah ta'ala. The man who came to the Prophet ﷺ in a masjid, and he said, Assalamu alaikum ya Rasulullah. After he had prayed, the Prophet said, idhab, fasalli, fa innaka lam tusalli. Go back, pray, you have not prayed. Go back, pray, you have not prayed. So the man went back and he prayed, he came back. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, idhab, fasalli, fa innaka lam tusalli. Go back, pray, you haven't prayed. After many times going back and coming back and going and come back, the man said to the Prophet, O Messenger of Allah, this is all I could do. Wallahi, I can't pray better than this. So the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam taught him how to pray. This hadith has got so much fawaid and benefits in it. So the scholars refer to it as what? The hadith of what? Al-musi'u salatahu. The one who prayed incorrectly. That's what the hadith got referred to. What did the Messenger command him? He said to him, إِذَا قُمْتَ إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ if you stand up to the prayer. Stand up is what the Prophet said. فَأَسْبِغِ الْوُضُوءَ make sure you make the wudu reach every part. ثُمَّ اسْتَقْبِلِ الْقِبْلَةَ فَكَبِّرْ and then face the qibla and say Allahu Akbar. So this is what is the Prophet commanding him? Standing up. Once you stood up, or you want to stand up for the prayer, this is what you do. And anybody who leaves off a pillar, aliman, he has knowledge, number one. مُخْتَارًا لِفِعْلِهِ and also he's the one who chose it. He wasn't forced to do it. He wasn't under any duress. He chose it from his own will. And it is also قادر, he's able to do it. As I mentioned, قادرًا عَالِمًا مُخْتَارًا لِفِعْلِهِ those three. Anyone who doesn't come on any pillar. Are you able to do it? نعم. Do you know? نعم, you know the ruling. Third one is what? It's your choice. مُخْتَارًا لِفِعْلِهِ anyone who leaves that off, فَصَلَاتُ بَاطِلَةٌ بِإِجْمَعِ الْعُلَمَى your salah is batil if you leave that pillar. And this is a consensus. وَقَدْ نَصَّ عَلَى الْإِجْمَاعِ the person who mentioned this ijma' is al-imamu al-ajurri rahimahullah. Ibn Hubayrah, Ibn Hazm, al-Nawawi, Ibn Qudama. وَغَيْرُهُمْ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ other than them from the people of knowledge. And inshallah ta'ala, don't worry, we will bring every one of them their statements. So, this is something you have to understand. لكن, but, this hukum that we just mentioned right now, لا ينطبق على صلاة النافلة. But that doesn't refer, it doesn't deal with the voluntary prayers. The voluntary prayers, the hukum is different. The reason is because the salah which are nawafil, تتشوف الشريعة إلى فعلها. The sharia desires for you to come with it. وتتسامح في بعض. And then the sharia also, it forgives you and allows you and lets you go on some of the actions of the nawafil. So a person is allowed to pray a nafila sitting down, even though he has the ability. He's allowed to sit down and pray. He can sit on a chair. He can sit on whatever he wishes, even that he has the ability to do it. But, his prayer is going to be half of the one who's standing. Based on the hadith al-Imam al-Bukhari narrated in hadith Imran ibn Husayn, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ صَلَّ قَائِمًا فهو أفضل ومن صلى قاعدا فله نصف أجر القائم ومن صلى نائما فله نصف أجر القاعد. The messenger said, the one who prays standing up is best. أفضل صيغة المبالغة صحيح على وزني أفعل the best. وَمَنْ صَلَّ قَاعِدًا and anyone who prays sitting down فَلَهُ نِصْفُ أَجْرِ الْقَائِمِ he gets half of the reward of the one who is standing up. وَمَنْ صَلَّ قَائِمًا and the one وَمَنْ صَلَّ نَائِمًا sorry and anyone who prays sleeping, lying down فَلَهُ نِصْفُ أَجْرِ الْقَاعِدِ he gets half of the reward of the one who is sitting. And it is also transmitted that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi akhir hayati in his last stages of his life alayhi salatu wasalam he used to pray sitting down. The hadith of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha in the hadith of Aisha which you find in Sahih Muslim she said lam yamut rasulullah the messenger did not die hatta kana kathirun min salatihi wa huwa jalisun a lot of his prayers they used to be a lot of his prayers, they used to be sitting down, alayhi salatu wasalam. My beloved brothers and sisters, I've already dealt with one point right now in the muqaddimah. Muqaddimah is 3 points I'm going to be speaking about. The first one is done, and that is what? The salah has arkan pillars, la tasihu biha, without it, the salah won't exist. And I said, if the person can do it with what? If he's got qudra, he's got ilm, and he has the choice, he has to do it. Sahih? And if he doesn't, فَصَلَاتُهُ بَاطِلَةٌ بِإِجْمَعِ الْعُلَمَاءِ His salah is batil by consensus of the scholars. صحيح؟ And I said this consensus was brought by Imam al-Ajurri, Ibn Hubayra, Ibn Hazm, al-Nawawi, Ibn Qudam, and others. The second point that I'm going to speak about, inshallah ta'ala, is what? Pay attention here. The second point that I'm going to speak about, which is the ibadat, the acts of worship that we come with, is connected to, mutawakifun. It is connected to what? Ala al-istita'ati wal-qudra. It is connected to our abilities. It is connected to our istita'a and our qudra, our ability. So any Muslim who is unable to stand for something, he can't do it because he's unable to do it. Whichever pillar it is in the prayer, such as al-qiyam, al-ruku', al-sujood, or other than them, فهو معذور شرعان. In the sharia, you're excused. You're excused. And also you're excused aqlan, صح? Based on the ayah of the Quran where Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. That Allah does not burden a soul more than what he can carry. Also the Prophet sallallahu also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, فاتقوا الله ما استطعتم. فاتقوا الله ما استطعتم. Fear Allah, be conscious of Allah, based on what? مَسْتَطَعْتُمْ Taqwa of Allah is connected to your ability. وَقَوْلِهِ Also the statement of Allah تَبَارَكُ وَتَعَالَى وَمَا جَعَلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ مِنْ حَرَجٍ Allah has not placed in this religion a haraj, a burden on you. Also قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى And also the statement of Allah, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرَ وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرَ Allah wants ease for you, He doesn't want hardship for you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ Allah wants for you. بِكُمُ الْيُسْرَ Allah wants ease for you. وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرَ And Allah does not want hardship for you. Brothers and sisters, pay attention to this. This is very important. This is very, very important. Following the sharia as it is and adhering to it, saying that is what? That is extra and OTT is mu'aradatu li kitabillah. It's opposing this verse. Because every single thing, the way Allah legislated is yusr, is ease. Usr, hardship comes when the people go overboard. But what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made obligatory, whatever Allah tabarak wa ta'ala made sunnah, whatever Allah tabarak wa ta'ala made mubah, whatever Allah made makruh, whatever Allah tabarak wa ta'ala made haram, everything the way it is ease. So if you say that something Allah made haram is hardship, this is what? This is going against this verse, it's very dangerous. Also the hadith which is found in Bukhari and Muslim in hadith Abi Huraira, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا أَمَرْتُكُمْ If I command you, بِأَمْرٍ أَيْ مَتَى فَأْتُوا مِنْهُ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ Come with that matter according to your abilities. إِذَا أَمَرْتُكُمْ بِأَمْرٍ If I command you something, فَأْتُوا Come with it. مِنْهُ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ Come with that thing which I have commanded you, come with it according to your ability. Pay attention. Wallahi, brothers and sisters, we have to understand the source. The Prophet didn't say leave it, he said come with it. You what? You have to come with it. Because the Prophet commanded you. To say I am unable to do it in totality is not what the hadith is saying. Are you there? The evidence, what does he want from you? What does the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam want from you? What is wanted from you is that you follow it and you come with it, but then you come with what you're able to do. Also, Al-Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah narrated that the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam in hadith Imran ibn Husayn, which I quoted before, Salli qa'iman, stand, pray standing. فَإِنْ لَمْ تَسْتَطِعْ فَقَاعِدًا If you're not able, then pray sitting down. فَإِنْ لَمْ تَسْتَطِعْ And if you're not able to pray sitting, فَعَلَى جَنْبٍ Pray on the side. Are you with me? Look at this. Pray standing up is a command. But then look what it was said after that. فَإِنْ لَمْ تَسْتَطِعْ But you're not able, then sit down. But then I'm not able to sit down as well. Then, okay, pray on your side. Anas ibn Malik, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the hadith is found in Bukhari and Muslim. سَقَطَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ The messenger fell down. عَنْ فَرَسِدْ He fell from a horse, alayhi salatu wasalam. فَخُدِشَ أَوْ جُحِشَ شِقُّهُ الْأَيْمَنِ The Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam injured his side. Some narrations mention his shoulders. Alayhi Salatu Wasalam. He injured himself. You see? What the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam did was, he stayed in an attic. He left all of his wives and he said, I'm not going to stay with them for 29 nights. So he stayed in an attic, Alayhi Salatu Wasalam. The Sahabas came and they visited him. فَدَخَلْنَا عَلَيْهِ نَعُودُ We came and we visited him. فحضرت الصلاة the salah came فصلى قاعدا the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم praying sitting down وصلينا خلفه and we prayed behind him قعودا we prayed behind him sitting Some of the narrations mention that the Sahabas prayed standing up and the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم He told them to sit down. Alayhi salatu wasalam. Al-Imam Al-Nawawi and Ibn Qudama rahimahumullah, may Allah have mercy upon both of them. They have brought a consensus regarding this. That the ibadat is mutawakifun ala al-istita'ati وَالْقُدْرَةِ That the ibadat are connected to the person's ability. We brought ayat, right? We brought hadith, right? Now we bring the ijma'. And that's our manhaj. Quran, sunnah, and ijma'. The ijma' is Imam Ibn Qudama and Nawawi brought it. And others brought it, but I'm just going to suffice myself with these two. Ibn Qudama, rahimahullah, said in his kitab al-Mughni, first volume, page 443, أَجْمَعَ أَهْلُ الْعِلْمِ عَلَىٰ أَنَّ مَنْ لَمْ يُطَبِّقِ الْقِيَامَ لَهُ أَنْ يُصَلِّيَ جَالِسًا Ibn Qudama said, أَجْمَعَ أَهْلُ الْعِلْمِ The scholars are unanimously in agreement. The scholars and the people of knowledge. On what? عَلَىٰ أَنَّ مَنْ لَمْ يُطِقِ الْقِيَامَ The one who's not able to pray standing up. He's not able to. لَهُ It is legislated and it's permissible for him. أَنْ يُصَلِّيَ جَالِسًا To pray sitting. وَقَالَ النَّوَوِيُّ And Imam al-Nawawi said, In his Majmu', fourth volume, page 182, he says, أَجْمَعَتِ الْأُمَّةُ The Ummah are unanimously in agreement. عَلَىٰ أَنَّ مَنْ عَجَزَ عَنِ الْقِيَامِ فِي الْفَرِيضَةِ The one who is unable in standing in the obligatory, is unable to stand praying. صَلَّاهَا قَاعِدًا He prays it sitting. وَإِلَّا وَلَا إِعَادَةَ عَلَيْهِ And there is no repetition from him. I mean, he doesn't have to repeat it. وَلَا إِعَادَةَ عَلَيْهِ And he doesn't also have to repeat it. وَقَالَ الْمَرْدَاوِيُّ الْإِمَامُ الْمَرْدَاوِيُّ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ He said in his kitab al-insaf, the second volume, page 305, he said, بِلَا نِزَاعَ Without any niza' and discussion and debate about that, that's what the person needs to do. And of course, as it is, evidences from the Quran and the Sunnah and the Ijma', it also goes hand in hand with the qawa'id al-fiqhiyya that we studied, which is لا ضرر ولا ضرار. And the قاعدة المشقة تجلب التيسير. And the قاعدة لا واجب مع العجز. And the قاعدة الضرورات تبيح المحظورات. So it goes hand in hand with all of those qawa'id al-fiqhiyya which we have spoken about. So, based upon that, it is upon every Muslim who is unable to come with whatever pillars of it, the salah, whatever arkan of the salah is, to know that he is what? Excused by the Quran and the Sunnah and the Ijma. So what about if I am unable to stand up in the prayer? What do I do? The person prays sitting. Are you there? If I can't stand up and I'm unable to stand up, what do I do? Sit down. Based on what hadith? Hadith of Imran ibn Husayn radiallahu ta'ala in Sahih al-Bukhari. The Prophet specifically said to him, صَلِّ قَائِمًا فَإِن لَمْ تَسْتَطِعْ فَقَاعِدًا فَإِن لَمْ تَسْتَطِعْ فَعَلَى جَنْبٍ. So, you can't stand, what do? You sit down. Good. وَمَنْ عَجَزَ عَنِ الرُّكُوعِ. What about the one who is unable to come with the ruku'? He can't come with that. He can come with it. He can come with the qiyam, but he can't come with ruku'. What does he do? This is very important. These points are very important. The person, he can come with the qiyam, and he can come with the sujood, but he can't come with the ruku'. مثلاً. Whatever reason it may be. This person, it will be said to him, why, when you're standing up, go as far as you're able to go. In other words, أومأ برأسه حال قيامي. Whilst you're standing up, you go a bit down. Are you there? What about if the person can't do sujood? He sits down and then he does it from there. As far as he's able to go, his head, he moves it down as far as he can go. Pay attention, this is very important. You're not allowed to do the ruku' from the sitting position. And you're not also allowed to do the sujood from the standing position. Because the closest the ruku' is to the qiyam. And the closest that the sujood is to the julus, sitting. So the point, am I crystal clear in what I'm saying? So when you're standing, that is when you're closest to ruku'. So you do it with your head like that. Pay attention now. The ruku' and the sujood also has to be different. Even though the positions are different anyways, because this one's qiyam, and you're doing it with your head like this. Huh? The sujood should be what? Always slightly more down. And there's a hadith that is narrated, which is not authentic. Hadith of Ali ibn Abi Talib, and Imam al-Darqutni narrated it, and Bayhaqi also narrated it. They attributed it to the Prophet sallallahu wasallamu alayhi. He said, يُصَلِّ الْمَرِيضُ قَائِمًا. The sick one prays standing up. فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطِعْ. If he is not able to, أَنْ يَسْجُدَ. He is not able to do sujood. أَوْ مَأَ. He points it out with his head, like this. That's how he does it. وَجَعَلَ سُجُودَهُ أَخْفَضُ مِنْ رُكُوعِهِ. And he makes his sujood more than his ruku'. فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطِعْ أَنْ يُصَلِّيَ قَاعِدًا. If he's not able to pray sitting, صَلَّ عَلَى جَنْبَيْهِ. He prays on his sides. On his right side. الأيمن مستقبل القبلة. But facing the قبلة. And the way they said that he should face the قبلة is that his legs should face the قبلة. If he's lying down, his legs should face the قبلة. Because when he does the ruku' and the sujood sitting or lying, that his head's towards the, if he's on his right and his legs are towards the qibla, when he does his ruku' he's facing towards the qibla, they say. That's what they said. But this hadith la yasihu, it's not authentic. لأن مدارهو, because who it revolves around is a man by the name of Hassan ibn Hussein al-Urani. And he is a matrukul hadith وكان من رؤوس الشيعة. He's from the heads of the Shia. And also from the inner chain is Al-Husayn ibn Yazid. Al-Husayn ibn Zayd. And he is weak as well. But what is authentically transmitted, موقوفا, mawqufan an Jabirin. It's a statement of Jabir. وَلَا يَسْحُ مَرْفُوعًا. And it is not authentically from the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. Is what? صَلِّ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ إِنْ إِسْتَطَعْتَ. Pray on the earth if you're able to. وَإِلَّا if not, فَأَوْمِ إِيمَاءً. Show a showing with your head like this. وَجْعَلْ سُجُودَكَ أَخْفَضُ مِنْ رُكُوعِكَ. And make your sujood more down your ruku'. So if you're sitting right now, are you there? Are you able to do the ruku'? And the sujood, because you're sick, you can't even stand up asalatan. Both of them has forced you to sit down, right? What's the difference between the two, the ruku' and the sujood here? The ruku' is more up and the sujood is more down. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah said in his kitab Bada'i al-Fawa'id, the third volume, page 1155, he says, جَعْلُ سُجُودِهِ أَخْفَضَ مِنْ رُكُوعِهِ لِيَتَمَيَّزَ أَحَدُهُمَ عَنِ الْآخَرِينَ. The reason why the sujood is more down than the ruku' is to distinguish one from the other. وَعَلَيْهِ, and based on that, Ibn al-Qayyim says, and based on that, فَإِنَّا نَقُولُ, we will say, مَنْ قَدَرَ عَلَى الْقِيَامِ أَوْ الْقُعُودِ. Anyone who has the ability in standing or sitting, وَعَجَزَ عَنِ الرُّكُوعِ أَوِ السُّجُودِ, and he is unable to come with the ruku' or the sujood, فَإِنَّهُ يُومِئُ بِهِمَا. What he does ima. فَيُومِئُ بِالرُّكُوعِ قَائِمًا. So when he's standing, he does it from his, like that. وَبِالسُّجُودِ جَالِسًا. And the sujood, he does it from when he is sitting. Ayyeh? How does he do it? Muftarishan aw mutawarrikan. The sits are two, right? One time you sit on your leg, one time you don't sit on your leg, right? Whichever of you, it doesn't matter. Waqila yajlisu murabbi'an. Even if you want, you can cross your legs. When you're sitting, you got three ways of sitting. You can either do muftarishan. The last tahiyya, how do you do it? You don't sit on no leg, right? Or you sit on one of your legs. Or you cross your legs. You actually cross your legs. The way you're sitting now, it's called mutarabbi'an. You can sit like that when you're praying. If you're sick and you can't get up, you're sitting. The position can be like that. لقول عائشة رضي الله تعالى, Aisha said, رأيت رسول الله, I saw the Prophet of Allah يصلي مutarabbi'an. I saw the Prophet of Allah praying like that. Cross-legged. نعم, like that. Cross leg. Al-Imam al-Nasa'i narrated Ibn Khuzayma, Al-Hakim, Ibn Hibban, wa rijaluhu thiqat. All this is the statement of Ibn al-Qayyim. So here we learn from it, if a person is able to stand and he's able to sit, but he's unable to do the ruku' or the sujood, he does it from the positions which are closest to it. So the ruku', the qiyam, is the closest to it, standing. So you do ima' from there. And the sujood, you do it from that. Sitting, that is the closest to it. But if you're unable to stand or you're unable to sit, so you're unable to stand at all, you're unable to stand anymore, you can only sit, then if you're in this position, what you do is you bring the ruku' and the sujood in the sitting, because that's what you can do, right? But then you distinguish between the two. In what way? By making sure that the ruku' is a bit higher and the sujood is much lower. That's the kalam of Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah. Very good. What about if the person is unable to? وَأَمَّا إِنَ عَجَزَ الْمُسْلِمُ أَن يُصَلِّ عَلَى جَنْبَيْهِ. If he's unable to pray on his side. The hadith of Imran ibn Hussein pushes to the side, right? He's unable to do it. Then the scholars, they said, صَلَّى عَلَى أَيِّ حَالٍ. He prays in any way he could. سَوَاءٌ عَلَى ظَهْرِهِ. If he wants, he can lie down. Like, when people are in coma, or not coma, sorry, he's already gone, he doesn't have to pray. But what I mean is a person who is conscious, paralyzed, he's conscious, his mind is there, but he just can't move, for whatever reason it may be. Then this individual, if he wants, he can pray. If he's like that, he prays lying down, the way it is. Are you there? Or sometimes a person may be, he can't lie down at all. They've put him, he's in a position where he's sitting. They've kept him like that. Are you there on a chair? Then he prays like that. At that particular moment, he prays the way he's able to. Based on the statement of Allah, which is what? لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها فاتقوا الله ما استطعتم إذا أمرتكم بأمر فأتوا منه ما استطعتم. Based on all of those. Now that we've said that, everybody, pay attention here, who was unable, anybody who is unable, we're still on second point, anybody who is unable to come with a pillar, min arkani salati, from the pillars of the salah, or any other ibadat, wherever it may be, or any other ibadat shara'iyah, فَإِنَّهُ مَعْذُورٌ شَرْعًا. We already spoke about that he's excused, right? He is excused, right? But what he also needs to know is that you're not just excused. Rather, you have the full reward. Your ajr and your reward is as though you prayed that prayer fully. What I mean praying fully is that you have come with it as it should have been initially. If you're praying sitting down because you're unable to do it, you get the reward of the person who's praying standing up. You and him are the same in reward. And the evidences of the Kitab and the Sunnah show this. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, in the hadith which you find in Sahih al-Bukhari, min hadith Abi Musa al-Ash'ari radiallahu ta'ala anhu, إِذَا مَرِضَ الْعَبْدُ, if the slave becomes sick, أو سَافَرَ, if the slave becomes sick, أو سَافَرَ, or he travels, كُتِبَ لَهُ مِنَ الْأَجْرِ, the reward will be written for him, مِثْلَ مَا كَانَ يَعْمَلُ صَحِيحًا مُقِيمًا. He will receive the reward of a person who is healthy and he is a resident in the land. If you're a traveler, hey, pay attention here. You leave off some things, right? Some things you don't have to do. Sah? Every single thing that you left. For example, when you're traveling, you leave off what? Fasting. Huh? Are you the same in reward with the one who is fasting? Naam. Used to fast every Mondays and Thursdays. Huh? Or used to fast the fasting of Dawood alayhi salam. Used to fast the fasting of Dawood, which is kana yasumu yawman wa yuftaru yawman. He used to fast one day and miss a day. So you do that kind of fasting. But then qadarullah wa ma sha'a fa'al, you traveled and you couldn't fast. You get that reward, like as though you're fasting that day. That's the evidence for it. Also, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in the hadith Sahih Muslim, min hadithi Sahal ibn Hunayf radiallahu ta'ala anhu, annahu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala, that the Prophet said, man sa'ala Allahu ash-shahadata bi sidqin ballaghahu Allahu manazil ash-shuhada wa in mata ala firashihi. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, man sa'ala Allah, anyone who asks Allah, ash-shahadata, he asks Allah martyrdom, that Allah kills him as shaheed, fighting with the enemies of Islam, the kuffar, bi-sidqin, and he asks him with sidq, truthfulness, ballaghahu Allahu manazil ash-shuhada, Allah will make you reach the stations of the martyrs, wa in mata ala firashi, even if you die in your deathbed. Even if you die in bed. Even if you die in bed. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, as al-Ba'li al-Hanbali in his Ikhtiyarat al-Fiqhiyya, page 102, he said, talking about Ibn Taymiyyah saying this, Ibn Taymiyyah said, rahimahullah, وَمَنْ كَانَتْ عَادَتُهُ الصَّلَاةَ فِي جَمَاعَةٍ أَوِ الصَّلَاةَ قَائِمًا ثم ترك ذلك لمرض أو سفر فإنه يكتب له ما كان يعمل وهو صحيح مقيم. Ibn Taymiyyah said, anyone whose norms, عادته, his norms and how he normally was, الصلاة في جماعة, he would pray the prayer in a congregation, أو الصلاة قائما, or he would pray the salah standing up, ثم ترك ذلك, and he left off that, he left off the جماعة, or he left off praying standing up. For what reason? لِمَرَضٍ, because he became sick. أو سَفَرٍ, oh, he's a traveler. And the traveler cannot refer to as a person who is the qiyam. The qiyam, you're not missed out for this traveling. فَإِنَّهُ يُكْتَبُ لَهُ مَا كَانَ يَعْمَلُ وَهُوَ صَحِيحٌ مُقِيمٌ. It will be written for you what you used to do when you were healthy and when you were resident. So what stopped you from this right now is because you're not healthy. And the fact that you're not a person who is a resident, you're a traveler. Also he said, عليه رحمة الله, in his مجموع الفتاوى, the 23rd volume, page 236, he says, وَأَمَّا مَحْتَجَّ بِهِ مُنَازِعُهُمْ مِنْ قَوْلِهِ إِذَا مَرِضَ الْعَبْدُ أَوْ سَافَرَ كُتِبَ لَهُ مِنَ الْعَمَلِ مَا كَانَ يَعْمَلُهُ وَصَحِيحٌ مُقِيمٌ فَجَوَابُهُمْ أَنَّهُ أَنَّ هَذَا الْحَدِيثَ دَلِيلٌ. Ibn Taymiyyah is talking about the discussion and the debate with somebody, and he brought the hadith, and then he said the response to them is أَنَّ هَذَا الْحَدِيثَ, that this hadith is a دليل, it's an evidence, عَلَى أَنَّهُ يُكْتَبُ لَهُ, that it will be written for the person مثل الثواب الذي كان يكتب له في حال الصحة والإقامة. It will be written for him the reward in which الذي كان يكتب, that which used to be written for him في حال الصحة, when he was healthy, والإقامة, when he was a resident, لأجل نيتي, all of that because of his intention, وعجزي عنه بالعذر, and also the fact that he is excused because he's unable to do so. وهذه قاعدة الشريعة, and this is the شريعة, the قاعدة of the شريعة, a principle of the شريعة, أن من كان عازما على الفعل عزما جازما, anyone, whoever that person may be, who has conviction, unwavering conviction, determination of something, وفعل ما يقدر عليه, and then he does all that which he can, كان بمنزلة الفاعل, then he does all that which he could. But he's unable to really do it. But he pushes, he comes with whatever he can. Then he gets the reward of the person who fully done it. فَهَذَا الَّذِي كَانَ لَهُ عَمَلٌ فِي صِحَّتِهِ وَإِقَامَتِهِ عَزْمُهُ أَنَّهُ يَفْعَلُ وَقَدْ فَعَلَ فِي الْمَرَضِ وَالسَّفَرِ مَا أَمْكَنَهُ فَكَانَ بِمَنْزِلَةِ الْفَاعِلِ فَأَمَّا مَنْ لَمْ تَكُنْ عَادَتُهُ الصَّلَاةَ فِي جَمَاعَةٍ وَلَا الصَّلَاةِ قَائِمًا إِذَا مَرِضَ فَصَلَّى وَحْدَهُ وَصَلَّى قَاعِدًا فَهَذَا لَا يُكْتَبُ لَهُ مِثْلَ صَلَاةِ الْمُقِيمِ الصَّحِيحِ. Pay attention. If this wasn't a norms for you, and you never used to do it, it won't be written for you. Why would it be written for you? If you used to pray Qiyamul Layl when you were a resident, if you become a traveler, what would be written for you? The reward of the Qiyamul Layl. But if you never used to pray Qiyamul Layl when you were fine and you were healthy, and when you were a resident, then now it won't be written for you. There's no reason for it to be written for you. The third point that we're going to speak about in this Muqaddimah, which is the last one, inshaAllah ta'ala, is, there's a qa'idah that you need to remember. أن فضل المتعلق, the virtue that's connected to بذات العبادة, that's connected to the عبادة itself, أولى بالمراعاة من الفضل المتعلق بمكان العبادة أو زمانها. The virtue, the rights that are connected to the عبادة itself, are you there? Is more important in observation, it's more important to cater for than the virtue or the rights or the responsibilities that are connected to what? The place and the time. Pay attention. This is very important. Are you there? I'm in Mecca, the Kaaba of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Are you there? If it happens, a right that's connected to the prayer or the place I'm at, I give precedence to the virtue of the place I'm in, which is Kaaba, Mecca, over a right connected to the what? Prayer, is wrong. Are you with me? So here what we say is, in this situation, is this individual as a Muslim, the Sharia wants you to come with a prayer. That's what's most important here. The salah, the essence of the prayer, is more important. Are you with me? That takes more precedence than what? Than the rukun of the salah. The salah, coming with it, establishing it, takes precedence. If there comes, Right now what's happening is what? Pay attention. There's an excuse that the person has. The pillar cannot be found, but the prayer can be found. The Sharia will give more importance to the essence, the salah itself, because that takes precedence over the pillar. Just like the prayer itself takes precedence over the time and the place. So that's why the Sharia will excuse you if ability goes. If ability goes, the Sharia will excuse you for some pillars, but it will not excuse you for the prayer. So I'm going to conclude there, inshallah ta'ala. Next lecture, bi-idhnillahi al-kareem, I'm going to go into the ahkamu salatu al-karasi in details and mention the ways that it happens and the people and their perspective. When are you allowed to sit down? When are you not? And more details, inshallah ta'ala. Anything I might have said that was wrong or a mistake. فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي وَمِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ. That mistake is from me, a shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ بِحَمْدِكَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْكَ.